over these briefly here. We use Bestiary, the map marks mod for marking on the map, relic stats, run history plus, and the UI sliders, allowing me to move UI elements around. So hopefully none of these affect the actual events or randomness in any way, shape, or form. Just a quick reminder on the rule set for the Seed of the Week seeds. You may backseat, suggest playlines, tell me what to do in a combat or which card to pick or anything like that. You may not tell me random outcomes that are coming up that you learn by watching another player play the seed or by playing it yourself. So you cannot tell me the next elite is Gremlinub. You cannot tell me the next relic is Gambling Chip, that sort of stuff. So, here are the starting options. Colorless card, 3 one-hit point elites, lose all gold for a random rare relic for the boss swap. Looks like we have a modestly generous Act 1. Oh yeah, yeah, you need to have base game fixes disabled as well through base mod for full competitiveness. I do believe I am playing with base game fixes disabled. Have we completely shifted to silent? Not yet, no. Although I do plan on doing that pretty soon, actually. Right now we're playing the Seed of the Week, which is a silent seed. So I'm playing silent because somebody else told me to, basically. For legal reasons, do not ban me. Okay, I definitely like any act in terms of pathing where you get 2 elites after the chest. The more fires beforehand, the better, and I love that there's a shop here. So we'll probably go through one of these elites. We can decide whether we want to fight beforehand or not. So, can I snipe an elite? Kind of. I don't really like the elite snipe that much on Silent, as Silent already has very good, easy pool fights. Although I do like having 99 gold for this shop, I am very tempted by a random rare relic, as generally speaking. Lots of good random rare relics. That's right, you only get one attempt, quote, at the Seed of the Week. At least, you know, if it's to properly count for what we're trying to do here. You're free to rerun it, you know, and try to make different choices, but that's no longer a blind run on the seed. Okay. I could see taking a colorless card being okay here also. If it weren't for the shop, I would be already clicking on the rare relic option. I'm going to try the colorless card. I think the colorless cards do suit the silent quite well, especially Trip here. I'm also pretty happy with... what's it called? Dramatic Entrance, Bandage Up, Panic Button, Dark Shackles, and a few others. But Trip is certainly fine. 0 cost apply to Vuln. Build your own terror. And I think we're going to take maybe 4 combats on the way to that first fire here. With Trip, I'm not too afraid of Jawworm. Wondering if I need to take 1 on this turn or not. I think I should. It's only 1. Jawworm is definitely a damage race for the silence. Gotta be aggro or else this worm will slap you pretty hard after a strength buff. And indeed, if I hadn't played that extra strike on turn 1, this turn would be pretty bad. So I am very grateful that I made that choice. Floor 1 Catalyst, a classic. Oh good, and the seated command actually does work on Baylorbot. Good stuff. Sutzig, thank you so much for the Prime sub. Welcome to the Cozy Sub Club. When I first played all 4 characters, who did I enjoy playing the most? Ironclad. And is that still true? I'd say mostly. I think I've, over time, come to favor the defect a bit more. But I really enjoy clad. How far did the ironclad streak go? We got to 11. Then perished to a really unfortunate set of card rewards. That was a really tough clad run. Sucker Punch is not even that good, though, right? I'm really tempted by this Catalyst. Slippy Toad, thanks for the Prime sub and the 27 months. You know what? I'm going to do it. Especially since we have that shop coming up. Although, with the early elite, maybe that wasn't too, too wise. Maybe I want to go to another shop? No, we're good. We are pretty good. I'll take the random two upgrades as well. We get one strike upgraded and one defend upgraded. And my hope is that those will save us health compared to what we paid for them. Perfect fight there. 14 bucks and a poison stab, which is also the only damage card offered here. I will take the poison stab. So that we have a poison card to work with this catalyst. A decent enough start, I suppose. Oh, I like that as an abbreviation, Fele. S-O-T-W. All right. One very dead louse. We get a decent potion, 20 gold. Bane is surprisingly decent here. I think I'd prefer a dagger throw, though. Does decent damage with the trip, and the draw one, discard one can help us with our curse tolerance. But yeah, not a bad Bane by any stretch of the imagination, actually. Second poison stab would be more than welcome. Any other poison card here would be more than welcome. A pretty good turn one. Bring you to 12? Two strikes and you're out. Although we could also do dagger throw strike. Trip dagger throw works too. This is fine. Go to 12. Okay, this one needs to die next turn. This one doesn't. This one will buff next turn. So we can trip this one now. All right, a very good first hard pool combat for this run. Still only one potion. We might choose another fight before the elite here. We're offered Finisher, Flying Knee, Cloak and Dagger. None of which are too spectacular. I could take a Cloak and Dagger, maybe, to improve our hard pool matchup slightly. I guess Flying Knee is okay. What do I think is the easiest hard pool fight for Silent Act 1? Either the one we just fought, or the single blue slaver, probably. Those are very easy Act 1 fights in general. Or a really gentle four gremlins, like double angry gremlin, sneaky gremlin, shield gremlin. You just kill the sneaky gremlin turn one and then block. You always pick up Flying Knee on floor one. Is this a mistake? I don't think so. I think the only card that's really not that good for silence is Quick Slash. I feel like that one is just extremely underwhelming later in the run. But one energy is always useful. It does decent enough damage early on. I do think we need a bit of an edge in this elite fight, so I will take a Flying Knee here. And we're going to get to upgrade one card, which should probably be Poison Stab to improve both the direct damage and the initial poison we're adding to make Catalyst a little bit stronger here. We could also upgrade Neutralize, maybe. 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 Yeah, let's do one more fight. I'd love a potion here. Oh, looter. I almost forgot about this guy. He's pretty easy, too. Silent, in general, doesn't have that much of a problem with the hard pull of Act 1 because of the additional turn 1 draw, making life quite a bit easier. Look how thoroughly this fool gets donked by us. Easy fight. Very easy fight. In fact, the only damage we've taken this run is the 1 to Jawworm, plus the damage to the Burning Light event. We do not get a potion. We're now up to 70% potion chance, but we do get offered a die, doing lots of physical damage to every opponent. That's pretty good. Doubly so with Trip here, which can potentially make every opponent vulnerable. Is base game fixed disabled always or only disabled when seated? It's only disabled when you go into the mod options and disable it. You have to manually toggle that. Stormy Petrol, thanks for the Prime sub. Welcome to the Cozy Sub Club. Definitely going to take a die here. And let's see how we do against an elite. We're not that strong, but I do want the extra money for the shop for sure. And we should be okay with any half-decent draw order. And this would probably count. Is at least half decent, although I don't like that we drew so many attacks turn one. I can't play them all. That's good, though. Could consider Distilled Chaos now. I think I'd rather use it next turn, if I'm going to use it at all. We missed the die. I'm not sure. It's mostly blocks in the draw pile. We definitely play Poison Stab and Strike. If I play Catalyst here, actually, what's our worst draw next turn? If I play Catalyst, you go to 8 poison, so you go to 20, then to 13 next turn. Which would be a clean kill with die. Currently, die strike kills, is that correct? We would do 22 plus 7. Yes, that would kill already. So I think I actually want to play defend here. And then we either draw the die and the strike to kill the knob. Or if I bottom deck either attack, which is a 2 out of 6 chance, I believe, then we can just use the potion then. If I double defend this turn, we'll go to 10 block, the knob will go to 14 damage. So we take 4, and then we're out of this fight, potentially without even using our potion. That sounds good to me. Yeah, so just to clarify, I normally disable the base game fixes. Was my intention. I don't want to get a orb slot from Foreign Influence, for example. All right, we kept our potion. That's pretty good. We score the old coin. Wow, that definitely made a difference for the first shop. We now have 500 gold. Although I think that would have been the starting relic, right? If we'd chosen lose 99 gold for a rare relic, you actually just get 300 gold. So that's pretty sweet. We're offered another Caltrops. Seen quite a few of these. I think I'm just looking for poison in the shop now. I'll skip all of these cards. Yeah, that was the perfect time to find this money. Caltrops could be okay, but I'm looking for more defensive options early on, I think. Now that we have the base offense of the deck early sorted. All right, we're offered second Catalyst. We've had first Catalyst, yes, but what about second Catalyst? Seems a bit iffy here. I do like the Frozen Eye quite a bit, letting us know the draw order. I don't mind a Piercing Whale, although it's a little early for Piercing Whale. I definitely want this Predator for a big two-cost attack. How's it going, Climbit? Looking for roguelite suggestions. Coming out tomorrow on Steam is Slice and Dice, which we'll be checking out for the Steam release on stream. Very replayable. You can call it a dice-building roguelite that I think is really spectacular. If you haven't tried Hades, I really recommend Hades as a action-based one. Very, very thoroughly enjoyable game by Supergiant. Binding of Isaac is definitely a game with a lot of replayability that many like. Noita for the insane folks out there. You have to be a little crazy to play Noita. So do I want a Piercing Whale for 51 gold? Not really. Maybe yes. Let's go yes, really, actually. I'm going to get one offered for free, and it's going to be stupid, but that's fine. Whatever. Do we upgrade Dedai or Predator first? I guess for the Guardian fight, we probably want Predator upgraded more so. But Dedai really slaps the Sentries fight, as well as any fight in Act 2. Let's try the AoE upgrade. Let's do it. And this is a great fight for regen potion, maybe? Although, it looks like I want to play Trip, Poison, Stab, Predator, and then we can Catalyst next turn. I can Dagger Throw, Neutralize, Survivor, although drawing the Neutralize a turn early actually gets me the Defend, so yeah, it's worth it. Okay, cool. Oh, and now we know what the Distilled Chaos hits, too. That's great. Excellent. Catalyst. Although Dedai for 25 wasn't too bad either. I actually should have mathed whether I could get a kill here across two turns. Didn't consider that option. Probably should have. Yeah, we're going to be doing some Ironclad runs after this. Currently, we're at zero on Clad, unfortunately. Just how it is. All right, Lagavulin goes down without too much trouble. We score an Entropic Brew, two random attack upgrades, which is pretty promising, and a dash, which is a great card and could be randomly upgraded here. I'm going to take that. 10 block, 10 damage for 2 energy. And then we get Predator upgraded for free. I like it. We also get a Remove Transform upgrade here. This is a good chance for an outright remove. Although I also would not hate an upgrade here. We should be good against the upcoming elite. We should be good against the boss, and that means we can remove. Normally, I say you need to transform if you can't beat the boss. You need to upgrade if you can't beat the upcoming elite. But we're going to cut a card here, lose another strike. So we're down 2 strikes before even leaving Act 1. We're still rich. We've got some pretty good relics. Well, maybe not that good. We have healing per fight. We can see our draw order, and we have a lot of upgraded attacks, which does go a long way. I really like knowing that Dedai is the top card. That is so huge. So I could Dagger Throw to Dedai right now. We could also Distilled Chaos, but I don't want to. I'm gonna do 17 to all. So if I Dagger Throw and Predator, no, we don't Dagger Throw and Predator. We Survivor Predator, right? Bring it to 19. Next turn I can do Defend plus Dedai Flying Knee. And then the turn after that I can do Poison Stab Catalyst. So we're going to do 25 plus 20. We're going to do 45 damage to one of them. That's going to be the front one then. And I'm going to trip the one that I'm going to poison, which is going to be this one, I believe. Take 2 here. Take 2 again next turn. I don't think we're using a potion, though. Actually, I can't Catalyst. Miscalc that. Can be Dash Poison Stab? That's fine. remove the artifact with Piercing Wail, or I can just outright kill, which sounds even better. Kill this one. We'll block this turn. Gee, we're already dead. Eh, we're fine. A little too fast here. That's fine, though. Massively rewarded for our floor one catalyst, maybe, because we get Snekko Skull here, meaning poison is applied in bigger numbers. Although we still only have one poison source to start. Yeah, Noxious Fumes waiting room now. Bouncing Flask would be amazing also. Do I upgrade Catalyst going into Guardian? We could also upgrade Neutralize, Trip, or Dash. But let's get the Catalyst upped. It'll still matter in the Guardian fight. Quite a bit, actually. And Venom becomes pretty good now as well. With the Frozen Eye, I'm not too afraid of Guardian here. We can use the Distilled Chaos at a key moment if we know that we need to. Let's just start by drawing more cards and having more energy next turn. Sounds perfect to me. As long as I Dagger Throw, we draw the Catalyst next turn. Since Poison Stab applies 5 poison, next turn it'll be 4, 4 goes to 12. That's still pretty good. That gives us a very solid leg up in this fight. We do Poison Stab, Neutralize, bring the threshold to 1, and then hit it as hard as possible. Oh yeah, times 3 plus 1, so it goes to 13, excuse me. 13 poison. That's even better. Now have a trip. Okay, not a bad draw here. We have Piercing Wail to stop next turn. I could play Predator, but I don't think that I want to. I should play Poison Stab. We want to keep stacking poison. So this is probably defend, Poison Stab. Take a bit more. Yeah, let's do that. Does Vulnerable affect the damage from the poison? No, just the physical portion. Kaka. That poison will pretty quickly spell the end of the Guardian here. Okay, those are good draws. Take a little bit, but not very much, and then we win next turn. GG! Very solid Act 1 for us. We picked up a powerful poison card, a relic to go with it, and a bunch of other stuff. We have lots of money still, despite spending a bunch. We have a bit of healing, and we have lots of upgraded cards in this deck, too. Did you know that I play games other than Slay the Spire? It's true. Catch me over on Baylor Lord Plays for card games, RPGs, strategy games, and more. My question then is, do we take an after image for one block per card, or do we take a malaise to give strength down to foes? I'm definitely a fan of malaise, especially when combining with poison. Cards that slow down your enemies and basically you buy you additional turns are very valuable when you're dealing damage per turn. Take that malaise. Our boss relic options are Black Star, Wrist Blade, and Philosopher's Stone. Interesting. Black Star will give us extra relics from elites. If your deck is already good at elite hunting, this can be pretty good. I think we could do okay with the Black Star. The malaise works pretty well to shut down the Book of Stabbing. And with the Frozen Eye and the Distilled Chaos, we could probably get through a tough elite fight. The Hateful Nate, thanks for 41 months. Wristblade makes our zero-cost attacks deal more damage. We don't have too many of those at the moment. Didn't take Blade Dance or anything. Or Cloak and Dagger. So with a different deck, Wristblade could be very good. As it is, I don't think so. Philosopher's Stone gives enemies additional strength, but gives us additional energy. More energy is very valuable here with an X-cost card with lots of powerful attacks. Having more energy to spend goes a long way. Enemies gaining additional strength can hurt a bit, especially if those enemies are multi-attacking enemies, but we do have a couple of things that counteract multi-attacking enemies, the Piercing Wail, and then very notably the Malaise. With the Malaise, we can use the additional energy we have to take extra strength off of enemies, so I think the Philo Stone is a very good pick here and is going to be my choice for our Silent going into Act 2. My choice is also going to be to go to a shop as soon as possible here so that I can remove another strike, maybe buy something else. Looks like there are lots of elites this act, so Black Star Pickers rejoice, as you will have quite a bit of stuff here to choose from. Not so eager to get into regular fights. I think we could struggle in some of these. But we could also thrash our opponents in some of these. Example, here I know my exact damage this turn and next. Let's see, we got 17 plus 8, 25. 28. Next turn we deal 15 plus 13. So 28 plus 15 plus 13. So we can kill either the back one, or we can kill the front one and skip the flying knee. They don't actually benefit from the energy next turn. We'd save 5. But then I have to kill the back one in time. That could be trouble. Target the front one here. Just double check. We do 15 plus 13, which is 28. Yes, 28. Take not too much here. It could potentially be forced into using potion, though, for leaving this guy alive. Depends on whether he chooses to attack or not. He does choose the attack here. I think that's a good thing. Let's see. If I Piercing Wail, defend, we block 13, 19. So we perfectly full block, and then I can get rid of the Malaise here. So that worked out well. We just kill. Okay, that was good. Good use of the Frozen Eye there. Get another Distilled Chaos. I kind of like that. Dagger Spray Plus. I kind of like that too. Another AoE option with a free upgrade. Yoink. All right, Entropic Brew. What's inside you? Because I'm probably going to discard you for a second Distilled Chaos here. Yeah. With the Frozen Eye, these cards are way too strong. Or these potions, rather, are way too strong. So I'm going to go with double Distilled Chaos. Oh, holy crap. Biv Enjoyers Rejoice. Dead Branch is here. Could transition this to a Dead Branch run. There's also plus one strength in the form of the Duvu doll, which ain't bad. In terms of Dead Branch cards, we have Catalyst, we have Die, we have Malaise, we have Piercing Wail. Although Malaise isn't really a Dead Branch card. This is bonus cards sometimes at the moment. I think it's still worth it, though. It's a really good purchase. Yeah, stop messing around and get the dang branch, they say. You know, Twitch chat, you're not wrong. You are not wrong. I'll get the dang branch. We'll do it. I'll do it. Really like my potion, so I'm going to take 3 events on the way to this fire and then just kind of fight an elite as we are. See how that goes for us. But before that happens, I'm going to transform a strike into a poison stab. Now that's an improvement. Excellent. The catalyst further empowers itself. And we get offered a gold shrine right after leaving the shop. I could take money and a regret curse and then just go to another shop. Or I could take the money and just fight another elite. I think I'd rather take the money and fight an extra elite. We're pretty good at the moment. All right, da-da-da, what do you got? Okay, dodge and roll's not terrible. Accuracy is pretty bad. I don't see how that's going to help me, but I'll play it. Just to avoid drawing it again. Turn we can Predator, Flying Knee, Defend, maybe? Definitely Predator. Next turn we're being attacked for 11 by 2. I draw 7 cards. We can use the Malaise if I remove at least one artifact this turn, so that'd be a good reason to go Poison Stab. Alternately, can we kill it? Maybe I can kill it. If I play Poison Stab, Flying Knee. Goes to one artifact. Then we can go Poison Stab, Trip. Dagger Throw, Dagger Spray, Dash. So, let's see. We can do 6 plus with Vuln 15, 18, 13. That would do 52. Currently we're at 58. I don't play the Flying Knee. I have to lose the Dagger Throw. So we're only dealing 39. So I'd have to deal 19 this turn. Now we have to play the Flying Knee. And we have to play the Poison Stab. So I don't think we get to defend here. We have to take the 7, or the 8 rather. Take the 8 here, play both of these, and then we get a kill next turn. Or we could use a potion, but I think I'd rather take 7 here. Because I want both of these potions for this elite. I'd much rather take 7. Let's go Flying Knee, Poison Stab. We can do Poison Stab, Trip, and Kill. Is the Frozen Eye a shop-only relic? Yes, it is a shop relic. Go, go, Bower Ranger. Thanks for the 11 months of support. Ooh, Deflect Plus. Or a backflip? I'll take the zero-cost block 7 with the dead branch. I like that. And we can upgrade a card. Any card. I'll upgrade Malaise. Although upgrading Trip for these next couple fights is also a really good idea. You know what? Let's upgrade Trip. Wait, who's our Ekboss? Champ? Doesn't help us against Champ. Don't like that, actually. Against Champ, we have Catalyst. Yeah, whatever. This is fine. Okay, we are facing the Gremlin Leader. More like Gremlin Bleeder. And yikes, that's a turn one. Trip, Dagger Spray are the top 2 cards. Trip, Dagger Spray, Predator, actually. Which is telling me that if we distill Chaos, we're gonna do the good stuff here. Especially if we strike the wizard first. Yeah, that's going to be worth it. Strike the wizard first. I think they go in reverse order? I hope not. I think it's from top to bottom here. Trip, then Dagger Spray, then Predator. I guess we'll find out. If it's Predator first, then this could be quite bad. But I'm pretty sure it's Trip first. Sure hope so. Yeah, it's Trip first. That means the Predator has to hit the leader, which is excellent. And then we could do P-Stab Catalyst for 16 poison, or I could block for a bit more. Making 5 less sounds okay here. We've already done so much damage. We're drawing 7 next turn. So So we can do dagger throw, poison stab. Then we get the die in the following turn. I think we can defend here. I think we get to. Oh, with a bouncing flask, we definitely get to. You are dead. Take 20. Then we die. You do attack again, but we have a kill already. Good fight. Where's Nightmare? Where indeed? Where indeed? Bottled Lightning. Oh my. You can have any skill in the opening hand, including the trip plus. Or the malaise. Bottled malaise is pretty spicy. Take a backflip now. I really like Bottled Malaise for the late game. And for Champ, quite frankly. And if we find any turn one energy relics, it's pretty good too. Deflect on turn one could be okay. Bottling Malaise means we upgrade it. I already wanted to, so yeah, definitely. Okay, let's do that. Let's bottle the malaise. Although bottled trip is not bad, as mentioned. And I guess this one has more options than this one. Yeah, so there's no reason to go to the left chest here. We get Strike Dummy. Cards containing the Strike text deal 3 more damage. Currently only 2 cards in the deck. I say we skip this. This is a small boon, but not a sufficiently large one that I'd prefer to give up a future relic for. Rip, you failed me. For the last time. This is a pretty bad turn one. Strike, defend. Let's see. Currently we have 20 plus 21. We do 41 damage. If we randomly play these strikes... Actually, wait. It's not random, right? We have dagger throw. No, but I can't play all 4 cards. So if one of the strikes randomly hits the back guy, we can get a kill turn one. Or if they both hit... either the front or the middle, we could also get a kill. Otherwise, this is a very bad turn one for us, unfortunately. It's just not quite strong enough. We need to trip into anything, really. Or the die. I'm going to drink it. Let's see if we get the good outcome. That ain't it, unfortunately. That is just shy of killing anyone. We can at least draw deflect with a dagger throw. But yeah, I think that was the worst possible outcome for our attack, unfortunately. It's all right. Next turn is not so bad. Should have done that first, actually. Yeah. Actually, no, I can't do that first. It's the next cost. Never mind. We have 4 energy next turn and 4 good cards to draw, so I don't see any reason to mess with any of this. Let's just take our hits. And I can get 2 of them? Looks like I can get 2 of them. We P-stab here. Dash here. This kills. Hey, that's not bad. Might have been a rough turn one, but that's it. Storm of Steel. Yeah, really not bad as far as slavers go. Get Mummified Hand. I gotta love Mummy Hand Dead Branch runs. And with Dead Branch, I'm super taking a Piercing Whale plus. Is Ascension 18 where the Taskmaster starts to gain strength every turn? Yes, Ascension 18. That's correct. Do I dare? Also, I have no powers, by the way. Oh, I was just thinking, fighting this elite with no potions is going to be tough, but with a smoke bomb and a distilled chaos, let's freaking do it. Excuse me. You're all being very rude right now.
Caw-caw.
That's more like it. Oh. if I poison stab burst catalyst, how much poison is that? You go to 5? 5 then triples to 15, goes to 16. 16 triples to 48, goes to 49. 49 poison if I do burst poison stab burst catalyst here. That means not playing die, but with 49 poison, this fight's over. And I can just piercing whale again next turn. Yeah, this fight's over. Wrecked. Yeah, so they can't attack me again on this turn, and then they die next turn. It's that easy. It is, in fact, just that easy. Beautiful. Completely free elite fight. We even healed for 2. Yeah. That's right. Get angry. Get the Singing Bowl. We can now skip cards for 2 max health, but I'm not going to skip well-laid plans. You crazy? Better than Terror or Bullet Time. And Bullet Time's pretty good. I did, Iceman, I did consider drinking the smoke bomb while the gremlins were fleeing, just to see what happens. But I'm pretty sure that that glitches something. Tempting, though. Very tempting. Yeah, you can't skip well-laid plans when you have Mummy Hand and Catalyst. It's just foolish. You can't do it. Cannot do that. Let's see. I need to draw towards the stuff. My hand next turn. If I dagger throw, the next turn we get the well-aid plans. That's what I would like. Start with poison. Do I need extra energy? No way. No way. Did go for another attack. How rude. Not going to use a potion here. I don't feel there's any need for that. Pretty sure they die next turn. Super dead. Venom would be good here if it wasn't so expensive. Fortunately, it is kind of expensive. Another deflect plus? How about an escape plan plus? 0 cost, draw a card. If it's a skill, get 5 block. And I know if it's a skill. So, yeah. I'll take it. And I think we upgrade the second poison stab if we want champ to go well. Kind of embarrassing. But I think it's correct. Manget, thank you so much for the prime sub in the 14 months. 1 metric year until you're at 2 real years. Although this year was a leap year, so... 1 metric year minus 1 day, I guess. Is not resting here safe enough? I think so. With the bottled malaise and the frozen eye and the distilled chaos, we should be okay against champ. It'll be easier if we can stack more poison, though. Let's upgrade the P-Stab. Oh, and I owe the chat a dad joke. My bad. Twitch chat. What kind of pet does the silent have? Adorable cat, a list. Looks like turn one is going to be backflip survivor malaise for three. Bring champ to minus two here, and then we'll get the well-laid plans in play the turn after next. Not too bad. We get a new card off the Ascender's Bane. We'd ideally like to get a random poison card. Although Tools of the Trade is arguably just as good here. We want to get to play Predator for free. I like it. You're already weak? Still doing 18, huh? Ouch. And I'm frail. Ouch. Could be the time for Distilled Chaos. I think we just wait, though. There'll be other opportunities. Draws P-Stab, P-Stab. Catalyst is coming up. Okay. Rippling Cloud, here we go. Stack that poison. I'm gonna take Distraction, because it could be another poison card. Currently we get Catalyst next turn. Catalyst this turn. The Catalyst next turn. We want to get champ as close to half health, which is 220 hit points, as possible. And then poison him massively. The champ will clear all debuffs, which is why we have to make the two-turn impact of the poison as high as possible. Go. Catalyst now. 64 poison. Dang it. You're a little bit late, Nightmare. Although you could still potentially help me. Wondering if Nightmare Poison Stab is enough, or if we want a Nightmare Piercing Whale, maybe. Nightmare Piercing Whale seems remarkably effective at stopping the first execute from hurting us. Draw pretty much Bupkis, though. Okay, you're already weak. This is fine, then. Nice poisons, sir. All right, let's try this line. I'm a little hesitant here. Champ's going to take another 68 damage from the poison, but then is going to remove all debuffs, which is just a bit yikes. Just a bit. Keep the deflect. Only going to retain one here. Actually, no, we'll keep a piercing well as well. Although, if I... No, we want to... We're going to draw a six. We need to... And get three more, so I can only have one card in hand. Yeah, just keep the one deflect. All right, here it comes. 22 by 2. We could stop that. We can definitely stop that. Terror is nice. 10 by 2. Yeah, let's do outmaneuver. One more piercing round. 4 by 2. Keep Terror, Storm of Steel, Escape Plan. This is a weird champ fight. I like it. Top card is not a skill, unfortunately. Okay. Gonna be a little reliant on what Storm of Steel makes for us here. I might also play Predator for next turn. Yeah, let's do Predator into Storm of Steel. Then I have one energy left. Currently, we're not dying. We have 28 total, 26 damage headed our way. Any amount of surviving is fine here. Although I could just hold on to the Storm of Steel for next turn and do something like dodge and roll, flying knee. I like that more. These three cards. Drop to 10. 45. That's a big freaking number, sir. Please don't kill me. Yeah, I'm not weak, so each shiv is 6 damage proper. I think we have a kill here. Although Distilled Chaos won't save me, huh? I'm pretty sure we just kill. Yeah, this is a kill. Okay. Hiya! Whew! Okay, that was a little tough, but not so bad. Phantasmal Killer is cute. How about a Real Tools the Trade? Doppelganger not terrible with Frozen Eye either, but I like the tools with the mummy hand. Take the tools here. Two very good potions. Again, both of these potions empowered by Frozen Eye. And we're offered Runic Pyramid. Of course we are. Or we could go one more energy per turn. Given that I already have a Will 8 Plans Plus and a Frozen Eye, do I need Runic Pyramid? Maybe not. I'm definitely down for a Curse Key here. We've even skipped a Relic, so we can get 5 energy. Yeah, I rather like the Curse Key here, Thwishat. Yeah, Infrared Eclipse. I think trying to Nightmare something created by Dead Branch in that champ fight was too speculative, indeed. Too risky, especially when we could get through the fight without having to use the potion at all. Where is Baylor and what have you done with him? What do you mean you didn't take Pyramid? What do you mean? How could this happen? Don't even have to open the chest. That's right. Okay, let's get us to an early shop here. I would love to remove another strike card, even though they're upgraded at this point. They can be gone. I'd also like to find a freaking poison card. Any kind of poison card would do, really. Any at all. What's the most predictable silent card? The Poisson Stab. Oof. Oof, I say. Ancient Pot's kind of nice. Escape plans are objectively correct, though. Take those. Yeah, these potions are too good. Ninja Scroll is here. Pretty underwhelming shop otherwise, unfortunately. Yikes. Big spooky number. No. Terrible. This one's already dead. You die to... You don't die, actually. Interesting. Maybe if we get a random attack card. Good enough. Be gone. Blade Dance is here. For dead branch things. Not gonna fall for it, though. What I am gonna do is fight a boss. Although, this is not a terrible upgrade all, actually. Not at all. I'm gonna fight a boss. Order. This ghost is toast. That, you stinky ghost. The power. All that, we get an unceasing top. We have no cards in our hand, we'll draw more. That's kind of, whatever. I'll take another Piercing Whale. They're very good for the late game, and even more so with the dead branch. Actually, not the world's worst Caltrops. Although, I think I need a bit more of a defensive toolkit first. Now we begin to fall. Lose the other strike plus. Cool. This deck has no strikes. And that's just how I like it. Upgrade a card. Tools upgrade is okay. Might consider upgrading Survivor or something. Let's fight the Elite first, then. Don't have a very good upgrade. How did I like the Biomes and Chimera mods together? I liked them a lot. We're going to be back to the combination of Biomes, Chimera in the future, for sure. Yeah, really liked it. Very, very much liked it. Wait, Unceasing Top. Draw me a card. Oh. At least we know what the top's gonna draw. That's kind of good. More than kind of good. Hello, Wraithform. Pleasure to see you here today. Recall. Trip. Let's hold the trip. Unironically good and ceasing top? I guess it must be, huh? Seems pretty good. Looks like we have the fight well in hand, even though our poison damage is not where it needs to be. GG, Mr. Giant Head. Good fight. Very good fight. We get a ghost in a jar and a question card and a wraith form. Okay. Seems good to me. Footwork's pretty good too, but is it as good as wraith form? I really doubt it. Take the wraith form. Now I have a card to upgrade. How convenient. How convenient. Corpse Explosion, where are you? Terrible. Let's play Wraith Form, okay. All is well then. A little while to get these bikers dead. 1,000 cuts will help. 1,000 cuts will help quite a bit. Could also go intangible and then kill them with our attacks. Take extra damage while you're intangible from the thorns. Let's just play this now. Here's Envenom. Envenom's a lot better now that we have 5 energy, by the way. GG nerd. Another great fight. Another catalyst. Okay, with 2 catalysts, I think we have all the things we are looking for here. Random BS, go! Don't open that treasure chest. We'll get a curse that we don't want. Fight the Reptomancer instead. Really, the Reptomancer is what we wanted. Smiley face. Have Ghost in a Jar next turn if things go really badly here, which it looks like they certainly could. Good luck to us. Crippling Cloud helps a little bit. But overall, it's a really big attack turn, and I don't have a lot of defense here. Hold on. Okay, we can keep the ghost in jar now. You died at this, you died at this. You take 15, but 15 is not worth the ghost. We'd even still take one if I use the ghost. More daggers to kill next turn, mind you. That should be a bit easier, though. A little bit. Cool. Okay, we can go deflect. Lands. Dagger throw. Take two more, it's fine. Yeah, this is fine. Not too bad. Okay, Catalyst mostly solves this next turn, too. Mostly. Here we are. Alright, Potions preserved. Not too bad a fight. We score a Toxic Egg, meaning this third Catalyst says plus on it, or we can take the Noxious Fumes, which might actually be better here. The Noxious Fumes effectively also say plus on them because of the Echo Skull. Seems to mean we need more poison starters, so I'm going to take the fumes over the catalyst. We have to go to the Burning Elite here. Let's go through another couple events here. Designer Inspire. Upgrade a card, transform two cards, or remove a card and upgrade one at random. I'm going to choose the targeted upgrade here so that we can upgrade our catalyst before the boss gauntlet. Vertex Shell, thanks for the 18 months of support. It's always good to have ya. Whoops. What I get for going to events, I suppose. We'll rematch Giant Head. This time, though, there's two catalysts, so I think this is going to go quite a bit better for us. This is fine. Lose some strength, Mr. Giant Head. Yeah, this really shouldn't be a troubling fight at all, by my count. More poison for you. Just looking for the other catalyst. Unfortunately, it's pretty far down. Means we're in a bit of trouble here. We can use expertise to draw a bunch, though. Let's do that. Only one more turn of being invulnerable, so we've got to do damage quickly now. If we don't get Catalyst this turn, we'd be in trouble, but we do get Catalyst this turn, thanks to the expertise. So, all is well. We win. Good fight. How's it going, Shoe Snorter? Did I pick Colorless Card or Rare Relic? We took Colorless Card on this run and started with Trip. Worked out okay. Why are you still here? Power Pot's not too bad. Dodge and Roll Plus not too bad. I'm going to take two Max Health, though. Bag of Marbles is good, as that will remove Artifact from enemies. I'll take one more event. We have two good potions. We have all the cards we need. I think we're fine. Panic button is very cool here. Panic button is filthy good for this deck. Basically, block one turn of damage. And I really like this alongside our other defensive options here. What we don't have is consistent base block. We have no footworks, no way to scale our block. However, we do have some things. We have piercing whales that can turn off multi-attack turns. So these are become invincible for one multi-attack. We have Wraithborn to become invincible for a series of single hits. We have Ghost and Jar to become invincible for any one hit. And now Panic Button can allow us to effectively be invincible for one turn as well. The downside of Panic Button says you can't block for two turns, but we can still go intangible or piercing whale. So we have a couple of ways to block even through the debuff of Panic Button, which I think is really good. We have enough money for one more card remove. I think I'll do that in the Act 4 shop. That way we can look at what the shop contains. Buy a bouncing flask plus, if there is one. And if not, we just do as we are. But want to buy a second Noxious Fumes? I don't think so. It doesn't stack all that well. It's only two more poison per turn than the base one. The discount prepared plus looks pretty good, actually. That one is admittedly pretty effective. And it doesn't affect my ability to buy a remove, but it does affect my ability to buy a relic in the next shop. I think it's still worth it, though. I'll take this. Okay, our first act boss, Donu and Dekka here. They've got three layers of artifact apiece, so we're going to need some powerful cards to get through all of their artifact. Oh, we already did it. All right, good talk. Good for us. Let's play Predator here. I don't think... I think I'd rather Malaise for more. It's going to be tough, though. Going to be a little bit slow out of the gate here. So I'm gonna lay Dekka, because we're gonna kill Donu first. Don't think I play that, unless Mummy Hand hits it. Do I just discard it? Or panic buttoning this turn? Discard the defense then. Yeah, so knowing we can use the Piercing Whales for block next turn, that's what I'm going to do. I play Panic Button now. I can keep Catalyst. I'll do that. Come on, Dead Branch, Corpse Explosion. Could make my life a lot easier. Definitely. Definitely could make my life a lot easier. Caw! To. All right, double quick slash. The power. We got retain one for now. That's fine. Yeah, retain one catalyst here. I think we have to play Wraithborn on this turn. Convenience. Okay, and we have double poison stab catalyst again next turn. Which I think needs to go on Dekka. Donu's already dying pretty quick here. Donu doesn't attack us next turn. Next turn, we're very vulnerable, in fact. Oh boy. Do I have to use my Ghost Jar next turn? With this draw, I might have to. Dekka takes 44, 43, 42 before they attack us again. More than that, actually, because of Fumes. Let's assume 45 by 3, which is 135. That'll kill them. Is it Unceasing top time? Ooh, it might be. Yeah, we're going to put all the poison on Dekka this turn. I can draw the Predator, but I can't play it, unfortunately. Also, I get a new card here. Okay, actually, I can still draw the Predator. Guess I'll take it. Can we do enough damage next turn? I don't think so, unfortunately. Doesn't kill me, though. Okay, hold on. Let's see, we can do Predator, Dagger Spray, Quick Slash. We can do 30 plus 18 plus 12. That's not nearly enough. Well, shoot. That sure looks like I gotta use the Ghost then. That's not good. Could try to use the Gambler's Brew instead, but with negative 3 dexterity, it's not like I can generate any real block here. And we have another boss fight, so I really do need the health. Yeah, we could be at 1. Yeah, we could be at 1, but, you know, fighting Time Eater on 1 health, I don't love that idea. I really don't love that idea. So I'm going to use it. We have the Master's Blood. No, you're right. We'd have 3 hit points. Okay. I don't love that we used our potion. But I do love that we have health. I do love that we're fighting the Awakened One. I'm pretty sure this is a good fight for us. Have to not use Wraith Form too early here. Discard Catalyst for now, actually. Fair enough. Fair enough, I suppose. Let's reset your strength. And Eviscerate for next turn actually sounds pretty alright. Well, for next turn. Okay. We have our fumes down, too. We need the fumes to actually do damage, I'm pretty sure, so. Oh, well. Oh, well, that makes life a lot easier. Okay, we have Nightmare. Nightmare definitely simplifies things. Pretty substantially so. Now we can simply Nightmare Catalyst, and I think this fight's over. Or we could Nightmare the Wraith Form. That also works pretty well. I think I'd rather Nightmare Catalyst. You're dead next turn, so hit you now. Keep both of these. Concentrate's good. Another multi-hit next turn. Also, I have no block this turn. Spooky. That is still not block. Maybe it is Nightmare Wraithform, actually. That gets us 12 turns of intangible. Not 100% on that. Surely 12 turns is enough. Surely. All right, I'll play your game. The copies of Wraithform are not zero cost, unfortunately. This is not how it works. Chain them. Now I won't be able to block anymore, conventionally. That's a little worrying. We do have a panic button, though. But yeah, this is the last turn where I can even block at all, which is a bit bad. Just a bit, though. They'll get to be intangible for a very long time. That's nice. We retain two, so Catalyst P-Stab, yes. And yeah, we have lots of turns to win phase two here. This shouldn't be a problem. Should not be a problem. Panic button works, at least, even with negative 17 dexterity. Can block one of the times threes. Good old panic button. GG, okay. That fight wasn't too bad, and yes, the Nightmare Wraithform was safer than I expected. It really didn't take that many turns to kill. Cool, that's encouraging. Two thump, two thump, two thump, a deep pulsing dread can be felt throughout the room. Is this the heart of the spire, the source of the seed of the weak? You prepare your daggers, dealing 2099. With just three easy payments, you too can own your own spire. think we need to sleep here. Currently missing 11 hit points, make it 9 with blood vial. Seems unlikely that any one of these upgrades would save 9 health, although the fumes upgrade is definitely tempting. Venom's a bit late. On sale, Phantasmal Killer Plus is kind of huge. I think we just want to buy a potion, though. Liquid Memories, for sure. To get any card from the discard pile. Allowing us to replay a poison card, or fetch Wraith Form that we couldn't retain, or something else. Whatever it might be, Liquid Memories will surely be good. Green is pretty decent damage for the energy cost, but we already have plenty of ways to deal damage here. So many rare cards in this shop. It's a loaded shop. So it looks like I just play a Wraith Form turn one? Question mark? I'm definitely going to play Piercing Whale. Alright, who needs to be poisoned to death first? Say shield does, right? I have so many ways to shut down the spear. We have to play the Wraith Form though, so Wraith Form first. I don't get to retain these poison stabs, unfortunately. A bit concerning. More than a bit, in fact. Take a little bit next turn. Keep panic button. That is so deadly in the early turns. And yeah, we can retain both of these, so I'll do that. Take 3 here. Okay, comparatively minor attack turn. Get catalysted now. More poison. You don't attack next turn. Oh, it's only multi-hit from the shield, so let's play panic button this turn then. Or from the spear. And then we can play glass knife. I'm not going to play the all-out attack because I don't trust it. I need both piercing whales next turn to avoid damage here. Could bring damage down to exactly 0. Is it usually better to go for shield first? No, there's no hard and fast rules in this fight. It's a unique decision every time, unfortunately. There's no easy way out. In this case, because of all the piercing whales, I decided to go for the shield first, since I could deal with the spear on my own pretty well, even with negative dexterity. Especially if I have 2 Wraith Forms, apparently. Yoink, yoink, yoink. I maybe could have blocked this hit by retaining the leg sweep. Oh well. You're dead, kid. You are dead. Get a Gremlin Horn from these two. Classic. How about an Acrobatics Plus for some serious card draw? I like that. Especially with my Frozen Eye. And as we go into the heart fight, really all we have to do is land some half-decent poison here. Surely it won't be that hard, right? Unfortunately, Noxious Fumes is the bottom card, which is definitely not desirable. We're going to want a Malaise for -2 at least here. preferably minus three. So two energy into malaise. So I can do back. No, we should tools first. Tools first. Dagger throw. Collect. Predator malaise. Hopefully we get to the well-laid plans next turn. So that'll mean the first multi-hit does zero damage. The first big hit I was hoping to use the Ghost in a Jar on, but we did not keep the Ghost in a Jar, unfortunately. So we could think of some other way to stop it. Wraith form does work here. Did not get the well-laid plans. This could be a good time to Gambler's Brew. Liquid Memories on the panic button works okay for next turn. We also can just take the hit, right? It's not going to be fatal. It does make me want to gamble all of these cards. We really have to get to that poison. Discarding the Void there does not stop us from losing the one energy, unfortunately. Discard these six, keep Void so I don't have to draw it again. I'm going to lose all the exhausting stuff here. Go defend Well-Laid Plans. Three new cards. Ooh. Interesting. But yeah, here's where Liquid Memory's panic button might be reasonable. Gonna be a lot of Beat of Death damage this turn otherwise. Pretty weak. Not with Willy plans. I think I want to keep this for next multi-hit. No, this one will work. Then we acro, discard, defend. Now we can play Envenom. Good, we got dash for free. Okay, here we go. Let's get started here. Yeah, I'm gonna Liquid Memories the panic button, I think. That seems smart. But also Liquid Memories the Wraith form. This time. Although that'll get us kind of slaughtered by the Beat of Death, unfortunately. Only kind of. I think I'd rather Liquid Memories the panic button, keep the Wraith form for next time. Although, how do I stop the next multi-hit? Or the next big hit, rather, if it's two turns from now. I'm not guaranteed to get back to my Wraith form in time. Don't take Beat of Death next turn. Okay, I'm gonna add Liquid Memories Wraith form now. Should have done this earlier in the turn. Hopefully we get the big hit first, but if not, we're still probably fine. Yeah, we get Panic Button next turn. Okay, all is well then. All is well. There is no need to fear anything. Good. That Envenom is really putting in work, actually. Am I sure that's not too early? Oh yeah, I'm quite sure. And yes, we blocked the big hit, so this really, really worked out. Big time. That gun on the bottom, though. Spooky. Very spooky. Catalyst this turn, so just hit it hard. Catalyst next turn, and it's dead before it can attack us again. Looks like we're good here. Oh, yeah, we do have retain 3, that's right. Doesn't matter though. GG! 543 poison for you, Mr. Heart. GG. You'll love to see it.
If you enjoyed that video, watch this one next. And don't forget to check out Baylor Lord Plays for variety content. Click the blue Baylor icon to subscribe.